partners, welcome back to Everything Kids Do. Today, I will be my Let's Play Slash Walkthrough for the Dinertown Detective. So, without further ado, let's get started. Okay, so for today's first mystery, we are going to head over to the zoo and be in the case of the polar bear bubble bath. Someone filled the polar bear pool with bubble bath last night. Bears look like a bunch of albino Abraham Lincolns. Okay. Bubble bath in the polar bear pool? Mister? This case sounds surprisingly calm and relaxing. Yeah, it kind of does compared to the other stuff. Okay. The polar bear. The white knight of the north. The great winter warrior. The king of the ice cap. Been watching the Nature Channel again, Bernie? Okay, so we have another one of these. Which I happen to be terrible at, but you know, practice is great. You know? I'm not going to improve if I don't practice. You know? I mean, that's how you improve at anything. I don't see anything here at the moment, so let's head inside and see what we can find. Apparently we can't find anything. Oops, sorry. Apparently. So, like, I could be looking forever for this elephant piece, and then it ends up being, like, somewhere, you know, like, if I put, like, the sea anemone here somewhere, and then it's like, oh, we found the last piece after looking for it forever. Okay, so I'm gonna use my hint right now. Okay, I'm gonna try not to use any more hints, but, you know, we'll just see how it goes. I really was hoping it'd be like, you found everything, you're so great, but you know, can't always be like that. Crowbar, up and away, the statue doesn't look right. A funny noise is coming from inside. No? Okay, let's see. The fish is blocking my view, let's just move him with a crowbar. Coral doesn't look right. See, an enemy looks ticklish. That's not right, but... It only looks like there's two in here. Two or three in this one. Maybe there's not. How can I get this clam open? In this game, we are very abusive to clams. I have just noticed. Nice, the guilty party must like animals. Oh man, seriously, no more pieces? What? Not fair. You should always get a piece, okay? At least one. Okay, so we basically just need like one piece for everything, one or two pieces. So let's see if there's anything here. How did I not realize? Hidden in plain sight. I'm not good at this. That's okay. Okay. Let's see. Fish, scooper, this fish. So bag of chips. What do we need for bag of chips? Funny noise is coming from inside. Oh, it's a raccoon. And this better have the other pieces. Okay. Pineapple on the hill. That would be a great name for a soap opera. I'm just telling you guys right now that that would be a fabulous name for a soap opera. Wouldn't it though? Pineapple on the hill. That's probably the extent of it over here. I don't see anything. Let's just click this. Perfect. So glad to hear it. So now I'll try and look in here without using the hint. It's probably going to be on the ground. No, what is it? Button. Okay. Here we go, button. Oh, and there's the feather! Did you notice I made it over 10 minutes by the polar bear exhibit without sneezing? Yeah, you may have finally found an appropriate pet, Bernie. A polar bear. Okay, narrow the suspect list. Oh dear, it's another one of these. All creatures, great to small. Okay, great. Great, get it? Ha ha ha, so funny. I know you're laughing. Laugh! Come on! There we go! Oh my goodness! The baby is the suspect. Whatever. He was guilty before, so I don't think he's gonna be guilty. But likes baby shampoo, wears raincoat, likes animals. My little brother loves playing with animals. Bobby, little baby Bobby. Bobby likes playing in the rain, so his mom makes him wear a raincoat. Where's a raincoat? Jo takes her dog for monthly checkups at the vet. She really takes care of her pet. Jo looks so creepy right there, I have to say. Jo likes collecting umbrellas of rare colors, but that does not prove that she wears a raincoat, but whatever. Jo has many types of baby shampoo at home. She says they do wonders for her hair. Oh wait, but maybe the umbrellas mean that she doesn't wear a raincoat. Bobby loves playing with bubbles from his baby shampoo. I saw Trip buying allergy medication once. He's allergic to everything, especially pet dander. So he's like, Bernie. Okay. But that doesn't mean he doesn't like animals. Whenever he travels, Trip always takes his raincoat. Trip only uses expensive imported shampoo.
Innocent. Guilty! Baby Bobby again!
Yay, bubbles! Oh, baby Bobby, so cute!
The case of the polar bear bubble bath!
And we're still missing that one, so let's head to the front yard. Someone ordered pizzas to my house with all the worst pizza places in Dinertown. I had to spend all my canasta winnings on tips for the drivers. Pizza's from the worst places in Dinertown, and they say there's no such thing as bad pizza. The unplanned pizza party. Look how poorly these pizzas are made. Only 3 tomatoes. I guess that's why they're the worst pizza places. Okay, sorry. I got a little hyper. All those pizzas and not a single one with double anchovies. Even a cruel prankster wouldn't stoop that low, Bernie. Okay, let's see. Cappuccino, ladle, pumpkin, flows a dress. Oithos. Two. The flows a dress, the guilty party must know Flo. Pizza. Yay, we can find pizza. Let's see. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9. Oh no, wait, that was 8, right? I don't know. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. That was cheese, not pizza. I got off count. I think that was a pizza, though, I think. 13. Uh-oh. Oh, pizza. 14. Or 15, I guess, now. Okay. Ladle, soy sauce, phone number 1, phone number 2. Clock. Oh, for some reason I thought there was a clock on my list. Okay. So let's find a ladle. Here's a phone number. This is the phone number of the best pizzeria in town. Someone has good taste. And here's phone number 2. I know this number. This restaurant serves the worst pizza in town. How do you know that number? Yeah. Okay. So, let's try and find the ladle. I see quite a few rolling pins, but I do not... Oh, here's a ladle. I do see it now. Okay. Soy sauce, white rose, cappuccino. Soy sauce. This is soy sauce, cappuccino. Okay. White rose, cappuccino. Is that going to be like a coffee cup? Come on. See some toilet rolls, quite a few clocks. There we go. Now we just have cappuccino. Come on, come on. Let's find it. I do not see the cap. Oh, there it is. Yay, I did it without any hints. Okay. Hey, Flo, you want to split a pizza? Okay, but I pick the toppings. Narrow the suspect list. Oh, another one of these. Sorry, there's a little bug flying around. Very irritating. Okay, count the toppings. Okay. So we have plain pizza. Everybody loves plain pizza, especially Mr. Chuck, so. He likes raw plain pizza. He just likes pizza. Okay. There we go. 2 pizza. Well, actually, pizza and farmer. I think it has to be cookie, sadly. One time, Tony accidentally ordered from the bad pizzeria in town. Why is he ordering pizza? What? He was furious. Orders bad pizza. No, because he did it once. A week ago, I asked Mr. Smith whether he had seen Flo, but he said he didn't know her. Those out-of-towners. I saw a farmer once ordering a pizza from the worst pizzeria. I once saw Flo with a mustached guy at the movies. Cookie is very health conscious, so he never buys bad products. Cookie, he and Flo have known each other for years. Mr. Smith doesn't care what he wears. He'll go outside in anything. Wait, let's go back here. Cookie is very health conscious. Never buys bad products. Okay. Well, that's like pizza. You could count, you know. Okay. There's one famous cook in town that has really good taste, but I can't remember which one. I often seen Tony at Coco's fashion show. Notes. Okay. So I'm going to assume that it's actually Tony who's guilty. I think we have our culprit. Okay. It's bad enough that Grandma beats me every week at Canasta. I don't actually know what that is. But then she said my strategy was as predictable as my pizzas. I'll show her predictable pizza! Pizza slam. Why would you do that? It's the unplanned pizza party. Okay, we did it. Alright, so let's keep on going. We have time for one more mystery today, so let's see. We can either go to the gym, the case of the 1 minute workout, laundromat, the case of the missing mates, clothing store, the case of the not so fun house mirrors, or the natural history museum, the case of the mummy's curse. I'm gonna actually head to the gym because I don't enjoy the gym mysteries. Someone has been setting the machines at the gym to super high speed. I didn't know they could even go that fast. I certainly didn't know I could go that fast. You are hilarious. Solve now. I'll search the crime. Hey, Flo. I'll spot you if you want to pump some iron while we're here. The only iron I'm pumping these days is a vitamin supplement. Ha 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 ha. So funny. So funny. Okay, it's one of these, you know, things that I really actually enjoy, but, you know, not very good at it. But that's okay. Once again, practice makes perfect, or better at least. The guilty party likes to read men's magazines. Oh man, I was like, I just wanted it to be like, you found everything. Like I always wanted to be, but it never is. It's locked. Nancy Drew taught me that it's locked. She always teaches me that. Who can lift such a heavy barbell? Our culprit must lift weights frequently. Trophy.
Knife.
The ball is blocking something. Needle, knife. Let's just knife it. Like what? Seriously? Why couldn't we just move it out of the way? That's my question. Where does the barbell go? I don't know why you wouldn't just move it, but whatever, I guess that's crazy. Protein bar. The guilty party must only eat healthy foods. That's not true at all, but whatever. Whatever. Okay. Ah, this towel reeks. Let's get rid of it. Ooh, that's a good one. We're gonna get rid of it. Whatever those things are called. Faucet handle. Claws, I like to call them. And then we still have this barbell, which I'm not really sure where it goes, so let's see. I assume it would go out here with, like, all the workout stuff. Isn't there... so I don't see any more here. I also didn't find a place to put this barbell, so hopefully we can find... Oh, phone number. Didn't see that before either. Where does this barbell go? Seriously, I just want to get rid of it. Where the barbell goes, yeah. But I did not find the other stuff, so I'm just gonna rapid spam. Where is it? Okay, well, jam and chocolate crumbs. You feel like that would all be on the ground, so. Why is it on the ground? Good. Okay, that's what I wanted to happen and not end up actually using hint. Okay, so chocolate. It's probably gonna be back here somewhere. Where is it? Oh, there we go. Chocolate crumbs that look like powder, so maybe it's cocoa powder. I feel totally inspired, Flo. I'm coming back to the gym at lunch every day from here on out. I'll save you a stool at the diner just in case.
Narrow the suspect list.
These clothes are as colorful as a rainbow. Oh, this is fun. A week ago, Duncan told me he started subscribing to a men's magazine. Okay. Trip is very busy, so he usually ends up eating fast meals and junk food. Duncan, he visits the gym 3 times a week to lift weights. Unlike Marco, I never buy men's magazines. Trip was a former wrestling champion, and he keeps in shape by lifting weights. Duncan lost a lot of weight over the years. He says it's because he started eating healthier foods. At last year's fair, Marco came in last place in the strength competition. Trip, he doesn't like to read at all. Marco only shops at the local organic farm market. I think we have more culprit. Alrighty. My wife says I need 30-minute exercises. Sorry. I need 30 minutes of exercise 3 nights a week. So if I up the speed, and now I get it all done in one... Wait, what? That's a weird sentence. Look what it says. My wife says I need 30 minutes of exercise 3 nights a week. So if I up the speed... That doesn't make sense, but whatever. Oh, timer. Oops. And now I get it all done in one night and spend the other 2 nights bowling with the boys. But whatever. That's fine. Someone made a little mistake. Okay. The case of the 1 minute workout. Okay, guys. Thank you so much for watching this episode. We will solve the last... Well, actually, there's 4 mysteries left. But, we'll solve 3 more in the next episode, and then I'm planning on doing the big last mystery on last episode. So I want to thank you guys so much for watching. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe. And if you would like to purchase this game, there is a link in the description, just in case you were wondering. And yeah, I will see you guys next time. Bye!